Hello children, this is an extra class of explanation of atom, elements, molecules and compounds. Okay, so from your queries I understood that most of your atom, elements, molecules and compounds, this concept is not clear. Okay, so I have made this extra video, a small one, to just see that, to make sure that you understand all these terms, and how just reading the definitions from the book will not clear your concept unless and until you understand these things. Okay, so that's why I have prepared this small video. So please go through it repeatedly. I think it will help you a lot. So let's start. Okay, children, this is only a one slide video where I have given all the structures and possible things I have included here. First of all, children, see, I have written atom. Okay, what you studied about atom. Now, atom means the smallest particle of any matter. Any matter means what? Matter means, first of all, what I told you, anything which occupies space and has mass. Now, whatever you see around, in anything, whatever around you, you see, is made up of what? Smallest particle, which is known as the atom. Okay, now atom means, here I have given example hydrogen atom. Okay, so atom is the smallest particle of any matter, anything which you see around. If you break and continuously break it, and ultimately what you will get? An atom. Okay, so you have also given the atomic structure just alongside, which is not in your syllabus. Then also you should know what, how an atom looks like. Okay, so atom actually looks, for example, you have the sun in between, and all around you have orbits around, in these orbits all the planets revolve, isn't it? You know that in solar system. Now similarly, in case of atom, you, in the between is not sun, obviously. Here actually it is also called nucleus. As you have studied in biology, it is called the nucleus. Now what are this nucleus consist of? You can see blue and black balls there. These blue and black balls actually represent the protons and the neutrons. Okay, so in the nucleus of an atom, the protons and the neutrons are present. And you can see two orbits I have drawn. Now that is a very hypothetical diagram, or very ordinary generalized diagram I have given that, and these orbits contain electrons. Okay, so in the nucleus are present the protons and the neutrons, which form the nucleus of the atom, and around those protons and neutrons, that is the nucleus is the, are the electrons which move around in the orbit. Okay, not haphazardly wherever it wants, in orbits it moves. So this is one atom. Now it can be any atom, helium atom, hydrogen atom, carbon atom. Okay, now it only differs what, on the number of electrons and the number of protons and neutrons inside. Okay, so in that respect it differs. So smallest particle of any matter is what? Atom. Any matter is made up of atom. Now we come to element. Okay, so what I told you, I gave you the example of copper, remember? So what I told you, for example, if you are considering element copper, what first element is? A substance which is made up of entirely from one type of atom. Only one type of atom is there. For example, element of copper will be always having element, all the atoms of copper and no other other atoms, only copper. If you are talking about gold, now gold will have only atoms of gold and no other atoms will be present there. Not that in gold element copper is present or iron is present, no. Gold has a pure, means pure ones, if I am talking about 24 karat gold will always have atoms of gold. Okay, no other thing. So a substance which is made up of entirely one type of atom, no other type of atoms is there, it is called a element. Element cannot be broken down into simpler substances by any physical or chemical process. Now for example, coal is made up of what? Ultimately carbon. Now if you break, so what will get? You will get ultimately coal itself, and that coal which you get, the smallest bit of coal, is ultimately made up of what? Carbon. So it cannot be broken by any physical or chemical process, we will get the same element. It is not that we'll get something different. We get the same coal, and that coal is made up of carbon again. Okay, similarly with gold also. So element cannot be broken down into simpler substances. Now this is very important, which I'll just now speak. Elements can occur in two forms. Okay, two different elements cannot have same kind of atom. Listen this one. Two different elements I am considering coal and gold. What is written in the slide itself. Two different elements. Carbon is an element and gold is an element. Now two different elements cannot have the same kind of atom. Means gold and carbon cannot have the same kind of atom. They are different. Carbon atoms, carbon is made up of carbon atoms and gold is made up of gold atoms. Okay. So carbon element is made up of carbon atoms. Gold element is made up of only gold atoms. No other thing. So two different elements cannot have the same kind of atom. Elements can exist either in atomic form or molecular form. Very, very important thing. Element exist in two forms, either atomic form or molecular form. How we know that it is atomic form or molecular form? For example, I told you about helium. Remember, helium, no, we do not write H2 or H3. Do we write that? No. Silver also. Do we write Ag3, Ag4? No. Ag is written alone. So it occurs as atomic form in the normal state. In the free state in nature, it occurs as helium atom. Similarly with nitrogen is wrong here. I will just remove it. So gold is only a single atom of gold. Okay. Now molecular form means what? Element in atomic form means it will not have two or three atoms attached to it. Only one atom will be there. Okay. It can exist in atomic form. Molecular form means, for example, oxygen. Oxygen is, that is a molecular form, means a molecule of oxygen, that is O2, is a molecule of oxygen. Okay, it cannot exist as single atom, that is not as O. It cannot exist as O. Always two atoms of oxygen combine to form a molecule of oxygen, which can exist in nature. Similarly, nitrogen cannot exist in nature, okay, as only N, not an atomic form, not as only N. N is the atomic form, okay? And N2 is the molecular form. Why? Because nitrogen cannot exist in atomic form. It can only exist in molecular form. That is N atom, that is one atom of nitrogen plus one atom of nitrogen is equal to N2. Similarly, chlorine. Okay, chlorine Cl alone atom cannot exist. It can exist in molecular form. So Cl atom plus Cl atom together they bind by chemical bonds and form a molecular element. So O2 is also an element. N2 is also an element. Cl2 is also an element. Similarly, Ag is also an element. Helium is also an element. Carbon is also an element. But the difference is that silver, helium and carbon are in atomic form. Okay. Single atom, O2, N2, Cl2 are in molecular form. That is, the atom cannot exist independently. That's why two similar atoms, always similar. We have told in the definition, I have told only one type of atoms will be there in an element. So, similar atoms combine together by a chemical bond to form a molecule. Okay, so a molecular form of an element. Now, what does a molecule mean? Now, molecule is of two types, okay? Molecule of an element, molecule of an compound. Now, in the diagram alongside of element, let me discuss that one first. Now, in that diagram, you can see helium atoms. You can see yellow atoms, one atom singly, they are present, okay? So, that is an atomic form. Means they did not, it is not needed for the helium atoms to combine, that is two or three atoms of helium will combine to exist, no. Singly, they can exist. But in case of oxygen, there are also oxygen atoms. But the oxygen atoms, singly the atoms cannot exist independently. Two atoms of oxygen has to combine to form oxygen molecules. And that's why that element, that is oxygen element, can only exist as molecular oxygen and not as independent atoms. Okay. Now we come to molecule, that is molecule of element and molecule of compound. Children, in the definition, when your molecular formula of an element starts, you will see it is written molecule of an element comprises of same kind of atom. Now, that's why I have written this. Molecules can be of the same kind or molecules can be of the different atoms. Means molecules can be made up of same kind of atoms or molecules can be made of different kinds of atoms. If a molecule is made up of same kind of atoms, see molecule of elements I have written combination of same kind of atoms. So H2 means two atoms of hydrogen, same atom combining to form a molecule of element. Similarly, O2, same kind of atoms, O atom plus O atom combined to form a molecule of element. Similarly, molecule of compound. Molecule of compound means what? Molecule of element can also be called as only molecule or molecule of an element. Why element? Element means only that what? That always they will be having same kind of atoms. That's why molecule of an element means hydrogen, for example, hydrogen gas. Hydrogen gas is formed by the atom, same type of atoms of the hydrogen. Okay. Similarly, molecule of a compound. Compound always, when the compound one word comes, remember it will be a combination of different kinds of atoms. Like molecule of a compound, H2O. H2O, hydrogen is also there. Two atoms of hydrogen is there. One atom of oxygen atom is there. So, two different atoms are there. So, it will be a compound. Molecule of a compound. Similarly, sodium chloride. Sodium is there. Sodium atom plus chlorine atom. Two different atoms. So, molecule of a compound. So, molecule of a compound is actually only compound. And molecule of elements is considered as only molecule. Okay. So, the molecules can be of two types. Molecule of element and molecule of compound. If same type of atoms is there to form a molecule, then it is a molecule of an element. If different kinds of atoms are combining to form a molecule, then it is a molecule of a compound. So, the diagram alongside molecules of elements. See, molecule of hydrogen, same type of atoms. That's why molecule of elements. Elements means same type of atom. Similarly, molecule of oxygen, same atoms, oxygen OO. Molecule of chlorine, ClCl. Okay. Similarly, molecules of compounds. Come to molecule of molecules of compounds means only there will be different kinds of atoms. So H and O both are present. Two atoms of hydrogen, one atom of oxygen. Similarly, that is forming water. Molecule of hydrogen chloride, H, that is a different kind of atom, and a different kind of atom that is Cl. So different kinds of atoms are combining. So molecules of a compound. Students, hopefully I have made you clear about this topic. Now, go through it repeatedly. I hope you will understand everything from this part. The next part of this this chapter, that is where you have this some sieving and all those separation techniques are there, which I'll come very soon. Till then, goodbye and thank you.